Welcome students. Today we are going to do chapter number 3 of 10th class, and the name of the chapter is pair of linear equation in two variable. It is very important. So one thing everybody know about that, in the last class, in the 9th class, we have done equation of the linear, means equation, linear equation in two variable. Like we have equation in this form, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So many students must be aware of this. So if you will take here, a, b, c are constants. Okay. And x and y are variable. Now, and even you are very much clear how we can show this line. This is the equation of the, this is also equation of a line, straight line, means straight line is better to write straight line. Now see, so here we have a pair of linear equation, means we will be given with the two equation and in two variable. This is the single equation in two variable, and we will take two equation in two variable. So this will be of the form a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. So this will be equation number 1, this will be equation number 2. Now here the concept, so if you, these two equation will justify the name of the, means chapter, linear, these are the two linear equation. Why the word we have used the linear, means whatever the variable you have, they have the power 1 only. Okay, so need not to write here, but just giving the idea. Okay. Now see, these are the two equations, linear equation in two variable, and one very important result is there, means these are the constant and they are the real numbers, and the sum of a1 square plus b1 square will not be is equal to 0 always, means they are both cannot be 0. This is the useful condition. We may use this condition in future. Now here we have some examples. This is the first equation. These are the some examples of the linear equation in two variable. This is the second equation. Okay, so this is another equation. This is the second equation. This is the one equation. This is the second equation. Now very important thing is there, we have done this thing in the 9th also. So like you have this equation, 5x is equal to y. So you can represent this equation in the two variable, like 5x minus y will be minus y plus 0 is equal to 0. So here a is equal to 5. If you will compare this equation with this one, or you can say ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, if you will compare both the equation, then what you will get, you have a is equal to 0, sorry 5, b is equal to minus 1 and c is equal to 0. So this is the a, this is your b, and this is your c. Is it okay? So one very important result is there, you know that you can represent these line graphically, and when you have any equation, like you can take this equation, any equation, you can represent this equation graphically. Like I will take x plus y is equal to 7. Okay, even you can take a very small, like x plus y is equal to, you can take 2. Okay, so what you will do, you will make, this is the y axis, this is the x axis. Now here I am taking, you will make a table. So what is the recommendation? You are required to take 2 points. Okay, it is compulsory, but it's better to take 3 points, because sometime you have done some mistake. So if you will take 3 points, then things will be more clear to you. Now, you are, what is the meaning of points means solution of this equation. So how you will find, so always start with, you take x is equal to 0. If you will take x is equal to 0 here, so what you will get, y will be 2. And if you will get y is equal to 0 here, then x will be 2. So I am taking only 2 points because I am very much sure these points are correct. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, here is 1, here is 2, here is 3, this is 0, 0. Now, if x is 0, y is first point. This point 0, 2 means this is x and this is y. If x is 0, y is 2. So this is the point when x 0, y 2. Now this is when x 2, y 0. This is the point, this one. So you can join these 2 points. So when you will join this point, so this is the equation x plus y is equal to 2. So in this way, now, so what I have discussed here, I have discussed how you will represent a equation graphically. Means this is the equation of a straight line. Now, if you have a pair of two equation, means it, this is the one line, this is the another line, means there are two lines. And when you have a two lines, means then you have a, these three situation. Means either they can intersect at one point, this is the first situation, either they will not intersect each other, they will be parallel. This is the intersection line. This situation, A1 is the intersection line. Line. And then the second, number 2, B situation is the parallel line. Lines. And number 3, coincident. I mean, one line is coincident to other line. They are, sorry, C means coincidence lines. So the first situation is intersect line. When two lines are intersect, there will be one point common to each other. And if parallel line, no point will be common to each other. When coincident line, all points will be common to each other. Now, we are going to discuss very, very important result, that is solution of pair of linear equations in two variables. So this is the very, very important, because in this whole chapter we will achieve only this thing. Now, what is the meaning of first solution of pair of linear equation? So we have a linear equation, means we have a two state line. So when I'm talking about the solution, so you, when you have a first situation, like when lines are intersecting each other, so then there will be only one point common to each other. Then in case of intersection, there is only one solution. So this point is the solution of these two lines. One solution only. You will name it as a unique solution. So means when lines are intersecting, then there will be only one point common to each other. This point is known as the solution of the pair of linear equation. So you, it is very much clear from the second figure, no point is, when you have a parallel line, no point is common between these two lines, then in the second case you have no solution. Correct. In the third case, means how many points are common, you don't know, because even you cannot say how many points are there in a line. So if all points are common, so how many solutions are there? Infinite many solution. So whenever you have the intersection line, there will be a one solution. When you have a parallel line, then there we have a no solution. When you have a coincident line, when we have infinite many solution. Okay, so you must know what kind of how many solution you will get, whether solution will be there or not. So you must have the idea before solution, correct? So here I am going to discuss one question, that is example number 2 of your NCERT book. So what is the example? Romila went to the stationery shop and purchased 2 pencil and 3 erasers for rupees 9. And her friend Saloni and saw a new variety of pencils and eraser with the Romila, and she also buy 4 pencil, 6 eraser of the same kind for rupees 18. So represent this situation algebraically. So what is the meaning of algebraically? That we will discuss, and graphically also. Now the first what we will take, so the cost, that is very much clear here. I will take, let the cost of the one pencil is equal to rupees x, and cost of one eraser is equal to rupees y. So Romila purchased 2 pencil, cost of one pencil is x, so what will be the cost of 2 pencil? 2x. So cost of one eraser is y, so cost of 3 eraser is 3y. So total sum will be this. So you know that she has purchased for rupees 9, so this is equal to 9. This will become the equation number 1. This is the algebraic representation of this. Now Saloni purchased 4 pencils, means 4x, like 4x, and 6 eraser, 6y. How many rupees she has spent? 18 rupees. So this is the equation number 2. So this is the representation of situation algebraically, correct? Now see how you will represent this thing graphically. Now you have a one equation like x 2x plus 3y is equal to 9. Now it is very much clear from here. I will take the value of y will be, so 3y will become 9 minus 2x, and here y will be 9 minus 2x, so 3 will come down, you will get 3. So you have y is equal to this. Now to represent these two equation graphically, we will draw the two lines. So how you will find? You will take different point. First I am going to take x is equal to 0. So when you will take x 0, you have a 9 minus 0 upon 3 is equal to 3. So you have when x 0, y 3. So when you have a y 0, when you will get y 0, so 2x is equal to 9 means x is equal to 9 by 2 means 4.5. So x is 4.5. If you are very much confident, you need not to take any third point. 2 points are more than sufficient. So what is the second line? Second line was 4x plus 6y is equal to 18. So same is here, you will put x is equal to 0, you will put x is equal to 0, you will get y is equal to 3. And why we have taken this different point? Because these two points are, two lines are same. So even you can take 0 also. Okay, here they have taken 1. When y is equal to 1 here, y is equal to 1, you have a 4x, 18 minus 6, 6 into 1 is 6, it will be minus 6, it will be 12, x is equal to 12 over 4 means 3, correct? So x is 3. So now represent these two lines graphically. This graph is there. Now you have a first line means x 0, y 3, this is x 0, y 3, this point. Okay, but then y x 4.5, this is 4.5, and x y 0. So this is, this point is this 0, 3, this is 4.5 comma 0. So you will join, you will get the same. Now another is x 0, y 3, same point is there. Now 3 and 1, so x is equal to 3 and y 1. So you have this point. So it is same. So these two lines are coincident line, very much clear from the equation. Okay, I hope you understand. This is the representation graphically. Now here I have a third example in which these two lines are there. Representation, these are the algebraic equation. We want to represent graphically. So what you will do, if you will see, you will find the points. They have calculated the point. When they have showed all these points in the graph, what you have observed, these are the two lines and they are not, you do not have any point common to each other, means they are parallel line. No solution for these lines. Okay, that is another situation when we have intersect line. So this is the one first algebraic equation, means x minus 2y is equal to 0. This is another equation, means 3x plus 4y is equal to 20. So when you will see, when you will try to draw this line graphically, you will get this line, this one, correct? So what is the graph of this line? This one. Okay, so what you have seen, this point is common to both, means these one thing you have, it is clear from the graph, they are intersecting line, and whatever the intersecting point, it is 4, 2. So this is the solution of these two lines, and you will get the solution only when you have a intersecting line. Okay, now in exercise 3.1, the first exercise, what this exercise expects from us, we have a three question, question number 1, question number 2, question number 3. So I will try to explain what is our requirement. Now see, then first question. So let's start with the first question. First question says that, now first question. So we have Aftab tells his daughter that 7 years ago, 7 years ago means from now, 7 years back, I was 7 times as old as you were then, means as compared to present age. Also 3 years from now, means later, after 3 years from the present, I shall be 3 times as older as you will be. Is this intersecting line? Represent the situation graphically, algebraically and graphically. Now see what you will do. So let present age of Aftab is equal to x year, and present age of his daughter is equal to y year. The first requirement is to consider the variable x and y. Now from present, this is the present age of Aftab and his daughter, correct? So what they are saying, 7 years ago, means 7 years ago, you will subtract 7 from both sides. As 7 years ago, I was 7 times as old as, means 7 years ago, present age is x and y. 7 years ago, that age of Aftab will be x minus 7 and his daughter will be y minus 7. And 7 years ago, the age of the Aftab is 7 times the age of his daughter, correct? So if you will solve this equation, x minus 7 is equal to 7y, 7 into minus 7 is 49. So you can take x, 7 will shift y, 7y will be minus 7, 5, minus 7, 49 will become 49 positive is equal to 0. So x minus 7y will be plus 42 is equal to 0. So this is the equation number 1. Now, take the equation number 2. So, 3 years from now means present age is X of Aftab and his daughter. Means 3 years from now, after 3 years, you will add 3 on both sides. And I shall be means Aftab. I means Aftab shall be 3 times as old as daughter. Means it will be 3 times as old as daughter. So, when you will solve it, x plus 3 is equal to 3y plus 3 into 3, 9. So, 3 minus x minus 3y plus 3 minus 9 is equal to 0. X minus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. This is the equation number 2. Okay. So, the first thing we have achieved means algebraically, we have represent this. This is the equation number 1 and this is the equation number 2. Okay. Now, we have solved these 2 equations. So, when you want to see this graphically, means this is the equation number 1 that we have done and this is the equation number 2 we have done. And another thing is that if you want to show both the equation graphically, so here we have taken the points. Means for the first equation is this, okay, if x is equal to 0, you are getting y 6, x 7, y 7, x 14, y 14, okay. So similarly, you can have the another equation, so you can get, we have taken 3 points, so when you will show these points graphically, now this is the line will be represented by this equation and this is the line represented by this equation. Now these are the 2 intersecting line and what you will see, they will intersect at these 2 points. So this is the way to solve this graphically. I hope you understand. Thank you very much, and rest of the question is for your assignment. We will see in the next lecture. Thank you.